Freddie, just straight up, do you want him to continue to fight?
You know, we've had a great 15 years together. If he retires, I'll be happy for him. That's kind of up to him. I know he's in physical shape to keep fighting. He hasn't lost a beat. His leg's so good. His work ethic is great. He could continue to fight on, but if he retires and spends more time with his family and he enjoys life, and he has something to fall back on because he possibly could be a senator by then, I'd be 100% behind him, yes.
Freddie, if he retires, would you retire? Are there any chances this is your last fight?
No, I'm not ready to retire yet. I guess so. I don't have enough hobbies, and I don't have anything to fall back on. This is what I do. I do it every day of my life. I got a couple young prospects coming up in the gym right now. I got Frankie Gomez fighting on the next big show, and he's one of my good young fighters, and I look forward to him winning the world title soon. Jose Ramirez, of course, yes.
And to follow up on your comment before when you talked about the volume of punches, I'd asked Bob about that. You know, Manny threw 10 more punches himself in the first fight in Bradley than the combined total tonight. Is there any way that the lack of punches that he threw is a sign of his age and the fact that maybe an older fighter can't get off the way a younger fighter could?
I think it's more of his mindset, and just he really doesn't want to really hurt anybody, and I think he was slowly getting out of that because he was throwing vicious punches at him. You could hear the punches land. They were really a lot better than it's been in a long time. And I think it's just maybe the beginning of bringing back the old Manny Pacquiao. So that's why I would like to see him fight again, yes.
Could you say a little bit about Jose Ramirez and his...
Jose did very well. He had a very tough guy in front of him. He won almost every round, but I want him... we have to work on his defense a little bit, and I want him to work behind the jab a little bit more because he does have a good jab, and sometimes he is a little carried away, and tries to knock people out from... a little bit too far distance, but he is a very good prospect. He's 18-0 now, and we're about ready to step up to the top 10 level type guys, and I hope he gets a title shot by the end of the year.